And we also have to talk about another passion.
Oh, definitely.
And I think you're sitting in right in front of one.
I am so happy to be in this room right now. Yes, I am with the Mini Cooper Club of South Florida.
Okay.
I purchased my own Mini over a year ago now. I can't believe it.
It's already been a year.
It still feels brand new.
Well, you know, there's something about Minis, and I guess you're going to have to expand upon that for us. What is it that you Mini owners are so passionate about?
Well, I have to say, I was driving a 15-year-old minivan and
not a Mini,
but a minivan. Right. I went from one extreme to another in a way. But I had always loved Mini ever since I was little. Actually, I loved seeing the movies with the Mini Cooper in there, and I was just enthralled with them when they were sort of brought back and yet updated more.
Updated
but
and technology and everything, yes.
I was having to rent a car for work whenever I would go across the state for any of the shows. And they put me into a Mini Cooper Countryman.
Okay.
And I had my kids with me, and I was stunned that I was able to fit so much in the car. The ride was so incredibly smooth. The pickup is insane. Everything about the car I was in love with. And I posted about it online, and then my dad talked to me about it, and he said, you know, you really need a new car. And there was no question. And I got my Mini Cooper, and I was able to actually customize it exactly how I wanted it. I wanted the racks on top because I love paddleboarding. My daughter's taken up surfing, and I like getting out there on the waves with her. And it's just sort of anything goes, ready for any adventure, and I still grin every time I look at it. So creating...
Now, I have to say something.
Yes,
though.
Yes, yes.
You really took it even over the top.
Yes.
Because you even invented a club.
Well, the Mini Cooper Club of South Florida came about from the passion and discovering that everybody who has a Mini Cooper shares that same passion, and they're always up for an adventure. So creating the club really brought together a number of other passionate Mini Club owners, and they are just as go, go, go.
Well, I noticed on some videos, you guys have had some great fun because there was like this Beatles thing, right?
Yes, it was
singing, karaoke.
The premiere of the movie yesterday, which was What If the Beatles Had Never Existed. And
cool movie.
Yes.
Comedy.
And of course, you know, the Fab Four sort of put the Mini Cooper in the popular culture track, but it's come to a whole new generation.
But the thing is, when you did that event, it wasn't only the movie yesterday, but then you had karaoke. They were singing Beatles songs and
yes,
having fun.
Everybody. And the ladies had fun getting to put on the little go-go dresses and everything. And for me, I mean, I wasn't alive back then when it, you know, back in the days of the Beatles.
But it was retro.
But the music is just like the Mini, timeless.
It is
for every generation. And we've done a number of other fun things since too.
Yeah,
we
I understand
had an
track.
Ice cream social.
Well, ice cream social, that's right.
The
some kind of
race
donation
track.
Thing.
Oh my gosh, at Palm Beach Raceway. That was amazing. We actually had a professional instructor there who was able to teach us how to get the most out of our Mini.
Uh-huh.
And even though I felt like I had done a lot of things up to that point with some of my own personal road trips in it, I learned a few things that I've actually put to real life test and taking my turns.
And we're not talking about street racing. She actually went to the track to do this in a safe environment, okay?
Yes, so we were in a fully safe environment and it was great. I was the slowest out there, but that's operator issue.
Now, I understand also that you led a pack all the way out to Lake Okeechobee.
I was thrilled for this because I've been blessed as a Florida native to explore our whole state and find all these little back roads and everything. And I was able to, along with the rest of the Mini Club, introduce a number of people into what really is the breadbasket of Florida.
Mm-hmm.
And that's go through the gorgeous agricultural places and just explore Florida kind of on-road, off-road. Go all the way out to Okeechobee and the Herbert Hoover Dyke there. And then we were in downtown historic Okeechobee where we all got to sit around and have lunch together and get to know each other.
Is that Nutmeg Cafe?
Nutmeg Cafe.
That is such a gorgeous place.
It is.
Every single chair's different. The tables are different.
The food was fantastic.
Food's fabulous, yeah.
And I mean, best of all, the company. It was such a beautiful ride.
And I hear the ride back was great through Martin Highway. That
scenic Martin Memorial Highway, and the trees form this natural canopy. And While we all got a little divided up there at the time, it was wonderful because each of the owners, they did their own little video clips and photos, and they were just thanking the rest of the mini
club. I saw those on your Facebook page. Also, you've got your own website.
We do.
Where event films and pictures and all that. Explore the mini club of South Florida. Elizabeth, it has been a pleasure. What else you got for me before we leave?
Well, actually, we are looking at, due to social distancing, keeping it socially distant, we can all be within our own safe space in our car and still do a drive out. We are planning on doing a trip to Naples. We're gonna have like a little road rally going there.
Great.
Kind of a sister city to Palm Beach. And just explore the West Coast for a day and back. We're having that coming up. And then we're gonna be planning, once things start to safely open, a number of other really fun events. I'm still trying to get a few other people to join me on a paddleboard. We could even possibly do that one socially distanced as well, since we'll be in our own cars and then on our own paddleboard. But a way to sort of get together, get out, enjoy, and just share the love of all things Mini Cooper.
Now, there's something about Mini owners that I see that they want to do everything with their car.
Yes.
They love movies.
Yes.
They love getting together and laughing and funning and all that. Now, you had another movie where you even had a dual event where it was kind of a little track and a movie. What was that one?
Well, if you recall, many of the Mini Coopers were made popular by the remaking of a classic movie, and my brain, guys?
Italian Job,
that's right. Thanks, guys. You see, they all have a future someplace else if it doesn't work out here.
You're gonna edit this, hopefully edit this part out because my mind just blanked.
No, I think we're gonna use it.
No. Of course, the remake of the famous movie, The Italian Job, mm-hmm. and what we did, thanks to Brayman, Mini Cooper, or Brayman Mini, was able to sponsor this wonderful kickoff event of The Italian Job, where we went and we watched the remake of The Italian Job, and then we ran outside and had a little obstacle course set up where each one of the Mini Cooper owners had to actually load the gold bricks into the back of their Mini and then run it around the obstacle course, and we timed it and everything, and it was phenomenal.
What is it about this car that you go into it as an adult and then suddenly you become a child?
I don't know if it's the toy-like experience combined with its incredible handling and its speed. I know that's what it is for me, but everywhere I go, when I pass other Mini Cooper owners on the road, they'll wave, they'll do a thumbs up. I notice that Mini Cooper drivers, they'll let another Mini Cooper driver go before them. And it never fails. Whenever I park somewhere, I will step outside. There will be another Mini Cooper owner who has parked their car right next to mine. And I realize I subconsciously or consciously do it myself. I see another. They just like being together.
Incredible.
There's sort of a bond that you find on the road. And of course, they're speedy everywhere. So if you want to go somewhere quickly, I usually safe bet to pull up behind another Mini Cooper owner. They're going to find a way around.
There you go, gang. Mini culture, mini cult. Who knows? You got to experience it. I've been sitting with Elizabeth DeShiel. Interesting, fun. Shakespeare by the Sea. Make sure you go to that. And the Mini Club of South Florida. All the information's on the screen. Elizabeth, thank you. It's been delightful.
Thank you so much for having me.
Club Brayman members, we'll see you next time.